Nick, here we are at the AJHL South Final against Okotoks after a six-game series versus the Drumheller Dragons, a series where the Dragons pushed you guys a bit, but you do get the win, wrapping things up on Sunday in Game 6. What was your takeaway from that series?
We knew it wasn't going to be easy. It wasn't easy. We obviously had to earn those games and, you know, that series. And, you know, I think the mentality of, you know, having to play consistently in all three periods is it's going to be a huge key coming up in this next series, and I think that's definitely something we took away.
After Game 5, when Drum came in here and beat you 3-1, what was the message that the leadership group had for the rest of the team to come out with the response you did in Game 6?
I mean, after that game, you know, we had to put it behind us and move forward, get ready for the next game. You know, play with a little bit more confidence and realize what kind of team we had and what we're capable of doing. And I think we brought that the next game and worked out.
So now you've head to the division finals against Okotoks, a team that few have beat this year. What will be the key then to putting the Bandits in the win column again?
We just got to be smart, play our game, be fast, stay disciplined. Like I said, I think we know what we're capable of. We just gotta execute and play smart and trust in the system. And like I said, just be consistent throughout the entire series.
You've been lined up with Will Guerin and Connor Jean, some veterans, lots of scoring. You guys have had a really good series against Drumheller. What is it that you like playing about with those two with?
They're easy to read off of. They're always moving. They can both finish. I know I can trust them with the puck, and I think they trust me too. And, you know, I think we all kind of have the same mindset of playing both zones and, you know, having good possession of the puck. And I think that's what gives us a lot of great opportunities in the offensive and defensive zone.
Well, you finished second on the team in points this year, 11th in the AJHL in assists in your second year with the Bandits. What was the biggest thing that you improved on personally?
Just stepping up, making the best of my ice time. You know, I had the privilege of playing with a lot of good players and guys who can finish as well. And obviously, I think that contributed to, you know, why I had such, I guess, good success with my assists.
Our friends at TCB Welding at the beginning of the year approached us saying that they wanted to sponsor your jersey with TCB and then the words Hammer Time written next to it. What did you make of that? And just for the record, I've never had a cool nickname like that, so was it nice to be given a cool nickname?
Yeah, actually I got to play golf with some of those guys there, Bill and some of the other guys, and you know, I guess it was pretty funny at first to kind of see a nickname like that behind your jersey, but no, it's all fun and glad I get to represent it properly.
Well, and also a bright future for you attending the University of Vermont. You are committed to that school. What does it mean to you to be heading to that school and be playing for the Catamounts?
It means a lot. It means a lot to me, my family. You know, obviously a lot of success to this program and credits to Ryan. And, you know, nothing but excitement to move on and to be able to go in an organization and program and school and whatnot. And, yeah, it's definitely a dream come true to be able to have that kind of opportunity and play at the Division I level. And I'm definitely excited about it.
And that won't be too far from your hometown of Ottawa. I gotta ask, what was it like coming from the nation's capital to Brooks?
I mean, it's a little different, but I've spent some time away from home, and it's not too bad. It's kind of nice being away and having a change of scenery, and I've enjoyed my time in Brooks so far, and glad to have experienced out west.
And your parents were able to come visit. What was that like to have them come to Brooks?
It's always nice when they come out and support. My parents love Brooks and love being around it, and they love everything about the hockey, and it's definitely nice to see them come around and show support.
And as for your extended family, do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have a sister, yeah. She's a year older than me. Her name's Chelsea, and she goes to school at the University of Ottawa.
Oh, what's she taking?
She takes business management.
So what does Nick Hamry want to take at Vermont, and where do you plan to see yourself in the future?
I'm hoping to take business and entrepreneurship. So,
excellent. Any specific field you want to get into?
Not as of right now, no.
Well, Nick, I got to thank you. Earlier this year, we did a school visit to one of the French immersion schools here in town. We do a lot of community visits in the year, and appreciate when the Bandits come out, and the students certainly do. But that day in particular was pretty awesome because we had you, P.A. Martineau, who's from Sherbrooke, Quebec. We had Arnaud Vachon, And I believe Nathan Plessy, who apparently knows some French as well, and yourself, some bilingual players, must feel like home when you get to go do an event like that.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely nice to practice your second language and you know, be able to connect with some students in that way. And, you know, to be a part of that, it was definitely special and glad I could contribute that way.
Okay, so before we let you go, I usually like to put the players on the hot seat with a bit of a quiz. So I'm going to ask you, you're going to the University of Vermont. A tiny state up in northeastern United States. What is the capital of Vermont?
Montpellier.
Montpellier, I believe is how the Americans pronounce it, but I've never been, so I'm going to take your word on it. Plus, you're bilingual and I'm not, so
yeah.
We'll go with that. Nick, best of luck in your future endeavors. Appreciate you taking the time to do this.